qualified as a teacher 18 years ago and began to set up some courses that I couldn't see happening in colleges, so more about personal and life skills. One of these courses was a healthy relationships course, and one of the students on that was Anthony Brooke. Part of the work we did on the course was to encourage the students to speak up for themselves and make significant changes in their life. So for some of them that was moving out of home from their parents and getting in their own place, getting support staff, getting appropriate support wherever they needed it. For Anthony, Anthony just wanted a really small thing. He just wanted to be able to play contact rugby like all of his local rugby team, and they wouldn't let him. So because the work we were doing was about speaking up for yourself, and because there didn't seem to be anybody who could help him achieve this ambition of playing a contact sport when everybody else with a learning disability was playing tag, Anthony wrote to, as part of his class, wrote to West Yorkshire Sport, and James Brown of West Yorkshire Sport then gave us the contact addresses for local rugby league and rugby union representatives. And the first person to get back in touch was Hamish Pratt from the RFU.
A few years ago I got a telephone call on a fateful day wondering if I'd like to go along and maybe help a few guys, a few wheelchairs at the time, play a bit of rugby. So I got myself and my community coaches along, and there was about, oh goodness, there was six coaches and about three players, and at the time we just had a bit of fun kicking around a rugby ball. I mean, it came through a county sports partnership. So the conversation started, and before we know it, a guy called Gooders came up and tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Are you keen to get involved?" And from it, this Bumbles, many years later, started to evolve.
The first training session was on a nice, hot summer's day. We were off the pitches, we were just playing on the side. We had one, two, three coaches from the RFU come down. We had a couple of coaches come from the Bradford and Bingley Rugby Club. I was there, I'd never played rugby before in my life.
In the first session, we had less players. Like, when me, Anthony and Ryan came, and I don't know if you know Quid, but we're not here anymore. He came and we did a bit of passing, running and all that, not tackling yet, but step by step.
First training session was quite funny. There was a guy in the wheelchair who's no longer with us, and we pushed him around for a bit. We watched Ryan, who's still with us, kick a rugby ball and do his best Johnny Wilkinson pose, hit the crossbar about four times. Played a few games, and with Anthony, he was tripping over everything all the time. But we just got, initially, what we do at a low level, just get them used to handling a rugby ball. And it's all about fun. That was it, really, just about enjoyment and about really starting to get them into feeling, being part of something. We had a photo, we went inside, had a tea and coffee, you know. It was great. It was just that slowly the wheels started to turn. You can see that within the players.
So one of our first games, probably the first game, I don't think we got a fully formed team at the time, was at a local club, Keithley, and it was a Fat Boy Sevens tournament. So a bit more of a fun game, really. And on the back of that, we got some good local publicity. And that's when Gwilym Lewis got in touch. Gwilym's the manager of the Carnethy Warriors, and they'd already been running for 13 seasons at that time.
Well, from a Warriors perspective, it started off in a day centre for people with learning disabilities, and they got challenged by a side that was in the Swansea Gladiators nearby. So there was already a side. Some of the people worked there. They challenged a centre to get up a side. That was about 17 years ago now, and it's built from there. Rugby's got a whole sort of culture that's all about inclusion. There's a lot of sort of team emphasis because you rely on specialist people. You've got to have a scrum at half. You've got to have a second row. And if it was, so whoever that person is, they've got an important cog in the wheel. They've got their own role, and it gives everybody a big role like that. It's got the culture of running all in and a good social culture around it as well. And there's a lot of respect for anyone who's prepared to play rugby. It's a big physical game. So there's a lot of combination of things to bring it together. And it means a lot of respect to the boys who do it.
he was able to sell us the model of mixed ability rugby, because it would have been a struggle, I think. It probably is a struggle if you're trying to play a rugby with 15 players who've all got disabilities, to understand all the complexities of each role, and all the possibilities that can happen during the game. So to have, we call them facilitators, but to have helpers, able-bodied helpers, has been a real boost to the team, not just in terms of numbers, but in terms of the game's much faster, much harder. The facilitators can help position the guys, keep them in place, teach them new skills as the game rolls along. So Gwilym's advice was invaluable.
The Bumbles trainer didn't think out of it, and then Anthony Brooke, who's the chairman now, he was just pestering me. Oh, if you filmed Anthony, you'll understand he's quite a driven young individual. And we were doing the Colts, and it came to the end of the season, and there's like an annual like Dad V Lads fun game. So we just said to Anthony, we'll put him on. We only did it as a token gesture and put him on wing, just thinking everyone would run round him, but you know, nothing had happened. First 5 minutes, boom, smash this lad. Everyone on the sidelines were a bit shocked. Then they were starting laughing, giving the guy abuse. Got speaking to Anthony, had a few beers with him, had a laugh with him. Went training on a Saturday, and I've been there ever since when I managed to drag myself out of bed.
About 2 years ago, I was asked by a player who came down if I would be interested in coming down and helping as a facilitator. And I turned up the first week with no kit, and the guy said, "Oh, don't worry, we've got some spare strip for you." So he threw me a pair of boots, and I ran out in a pair of jeans, a pair of boots and a t-shirt, and it started from there really. Thoroughly enjoyed it ever since.
I was coaching Gooder's son at the time, and they sort of, you know, introduced me to a few of the lads. My mother's always went with people with learning disabilities, so I wasn't sort of unaware of what it was going to be like, just not 100% sure, you know, how it was going to go. But did a great set of lads, you know, it's just like playing any other team. It's no different really.
I'm a driving instructor, and what happened was I went to see a new student and got talking to his father, who mentioned about being a manager for the Bumbles. And I got talking about how I played rugby within the army. And the next thing I knew, he said, "Well, come down and see us." And I went, "I'm about 55 years of age. I don't think you really want me to come down." So yeah, we're asking all sorts of different people to help us. If you can play rugby, then great. So I turned up, and mentioned to Simon. We both turned up. I made sure that I was in jeans and shoes and all the rest of it. And I said, "Oh, come on, come help us train." I said, "No, I can't, I've got no kit." 5 minutes later, I had a pair of boots, socks, shorts, a shirt, and out on the field. I'm thinking, what am I doing out here? I wasn't expecting this. But it was the biggest change of my life, because suddenly I started to realise my passion for rugby had come back. And it's a gentleman that I work with now, the lads, who brought that passion back. I then progressed from that to find out there was a coaching skill going. I applied for that, got that, and it's just gone from strength to strength. And to be honest, they give me more than I give them, because of the way they are. The way they come up and greet you, the way you meet you, the way they have a laugh and a joke. There's no backstabbing, there's no ulterior motives, it's just a love of the game. And from that point of view, I think it's absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, I've played with the Bumbles for a few years now. In the early days, my professional coaches that work in this area, Stoney, Spinner and Duxie, we had to sort of prop up the numbers. Now it's almost like a selection to try and get into the team, and unless you train, you don't get in, which is fantastic for myself. But playing with the Bumbles is a bit different, and there are a few big boys, you know, big fellas that play for the Bumbles, and unless you go quite low on them, they do run over you, whereas there's some other guys that are quite slight, but that have real different needs, and the way they play is a lot different. And until you can't experience it until you're actually in it, if that makes any sense. So we sort of line up the players and we sort of say, well, this guy's, you know, he's got cerebral palsy, be a bit careful on him. But until you actually see what they can do within the game, and for the first 10 minutes, it's a bit of, it's a bit like finding yourself. Oh, geez, that guy over there, that guy over there. And then you get an able-bodied player, say like our Gooders, who if someone says, oh, what's his disability, which doesn't go down too well. But what generally happens is after about 10 minutes, the players, because they realise that the core values of rugby are coming through, that we're not out there to smash each other, we're out there to facilitate a great game of rugby. So for me, the best players are the players that understand the rules of rugby and the laws. So they stand up big, you know, big fend offs, and we set up rucks. We set up 30 metre mauls, which is pretty unheard of. And we want people that to score tries, like every rugby player. So when we score a try, we celebrate, we have conversions. But when we're playing with them, we're just mindful that that first 10 to 15 minutes is a bit of a, it's a bit relaxed on the rules and regulations, just to enable both teams to work out, like an able-bodied game, is who's good, who's bad, what can you do and what you can't do. But look, these boys bleed, they hurt, they stand on me, I stand on them. And at the end of the day, we come off and we've played a game of rugby. But the one thing that I can say is they are getting better. They are getting better. And also the big thing in training, they're starting to recognise their deficiencies, what they need to get better at, which for an able-bodied player is hard enough. But for these buggers to start to realise that, it's pretty amazing. But yeah, it's good. It's good rugby. Come and watch.
When they had the meeting with the RFU, and they said, well, you know, you can't play rugby because you'll get hurt. And I'm not going to understand, but, you know, well, even if I have got a disability, or I haven't got a disability, I'm going to get hurt. It's a game of contact sport. And that for me just, you know, just sums up everything. Why should they, you know, people with learning disabilities or any disability be wrapped in cotton wool, so to say?
What happened was, when we first started playing, we put people in bibs, and they wore the bibs a couple of times, and then said, oh, I don't want to wear it. Why don't you want it? It says, because it's making me stand out, and I don't want to stand out. I want to be a part of the crowd. So one by one, they all took the bibs back off. So now it's a part of when we wanted to play them first games, I would get the opposition and say, look, we have lads that have got physical and learning disabilities, this, that and the other. I'm not going to tell you who they are, you'll have to work it out for yourself, but please don't hit anyone. Be careful. And rugby, being the game it is, just adapted. So the opposition teams, unless they're enemies on the field type sort of thing, local rivals, this, that and the other, and they want to bang hell out of each other, when they play the Bumbles, they just change and adapt, and it's a natural thing. And the more lads you get on that have a disability, the game just settles down. And as it progresses and more of them want to take a rest, the level of the rugby goes up. And sometimes you forget that you're actually playing in a game with people that have got learning disabilities and physical disabilities. Whilst doing that, people can get hurt. But it's everybody's right. So what we're going to do, we're going to wrap them up in cotton wool and sit them on the touchline and say, well, you can only come on, you can only do this. Or we put them in there and say, look, there's a chance you're going to get hurt. So we sat them all down, explained, said, this is a character of injuries, you could get it. Do you want to be a part of this? Yes, we want to be a part of it. He has a right to be injured if he wants to be injured. You know, we protect them left, right and centre. You know, you adjust what you're doing. When you're in close contact, you're actually discussing with the opposition. This is what, you know, you're doing it right, that's a great thing, turn him and put him on the floor. And it's just a great thing.
When I first went down, it was disjointed, but there was a good atmosphere there. And it was a lot more one-on-one coaching, where you literally had to watch everybody, and you know, it was just so hard to keep an eye on. It was quite hard to structure a session. Like now we've got, I guess you can call them like team leaders, like Asanu is sat there, and like your Pauls and your Marks, and it's just really good when you're doing a session and you don't have to watch them guys and they're actually coaching the new players. So I just think it's improved. One, there's a good atmosphere with bloody double, triple numbers. The lads are just taking things upon themselves. You know, we've got genuinely good players in the team. I know we've got the term facilitators. And a bit of people that carry the lads with the LD, but we've got lads with LD that are far better than some of us facilitators now. Major thing as well, I think the best thing I found out that I giggled at was the lads were organising going to like the cinema and on the piss together,
just out of a, I didn't get an invite, I'm still a bit annoyed about that one, but yeah, so they've kind of formed a new little group, social group, and even outside of the Saturdays they're still doing stuff together, which is good fun.
Certainly the 2 years that I've been with the Bumbles, the skills of the individuals have improved tremendously. 2 years ago when we started, or I started, a lot of the guys positionally weren't aware of where they were supposed to be on the pitch. So their spatial awareness has increased absolutely tenfold in terms of the game, where they need to be. And that links quite well with the fact that their spatial awareness, but also their awareness of their mental quickness in terms of keeping pace with the game has also improved. In terms of their physical ability, that has come on again tenfold. 2 years ago, a lot of the guys couldn't catch, they couldn't pass correctly, and in terms of their speed and fitness, they weren't there. Now, a lot of them are more than capable of playing at a 13 level, which is a good level of rugby, and they're also can play as a team. So they've understood now that rugby's not a team of individuals, it's a team made up of forwards and backs, and they know their place within that now.
I was told by various people that they would not remember things, they would forget, or they would not have good skills, and couldn't handle skills or movement. But in the 2 years that I've been here, I've seen a vast difference. Suddenly, their self-confidence, their handling skills have improved. They do remember, progress is by repetition, by making it so familiar to them that they do it without even thinking about it. Same with everybody. We all do it, but with them, it's a bigger achievement, I think, because suddenly they're not thinking about it. They're not thinking that they are this or the other. They are doing it because they love it, and it's there, it's within them. It's a passion within them. So yeah, over the last 2 years, when I've seen other teams who are now starting up, we've played against a team, and I suddenly thought, that's how we were 2 years ago. But it didn't come home to me until that occasion. Suddenly, I realised how much it had improved, because we've done it in gradual stages, and sometimes you don't see it. Now I realise how much they've come on.
I think it would be great because you'll be the first player, yeah. You'll be the first man coming through Bumbles that is going to do something special.
Yeah.
Just you. Would you tell us something about that, what you're going to do with the level one?
I'm going to do level one charting.
Okay. What's that? If I didn't know that, but what is
it's
that?
It's teach people how to play rugby. And two chest warm-ups, chest and out of the back to ball.
What are you doing now? When you have the training session on Saturday, what's your role now? What's your job?
Teaching some new people how to play rugby. I did it last Saturday.
What did you do?
Out of the back to ball in third line. Can person with a ball in front, met the old person behind the person with the ball to just warm up, how to run, how to toe tie, how to fall down the ball with the ball.
That's great, absolutely brilliant. There's another thing,
Haskey.
You remember the Haskey?
Yeah.
We got that film because Joe was there.
Yeah.
So, would you tell something about, you remember that? It was just last 3 minutes,
and I took
we were losing the game, and then
Tom Ferdin kicked, and
that was a brave decision.
Yeah,
it was. You were the captain there?
Yeah.
And you decided what?
I took the kick myself, don't need to all the team. I'm going to teach rugby next Monday at Airport Back 2, Nathan, Little Tit.
Do you enjoy teaching people?
Yeah.
Do you think I'm good at that?
Yeah.
Why do you think I'm good at that? Why do you think all the coaches picked you among the all as players to teach you?
In terms of the Bumblebees, education is for everybody who's involved. Nearly all of the able-bodied players had no experience of disabilities, physical and learning. This part of their knowledge is achieved through us putting on the presentation that we do, the inclusion in rugby group presentation, but much, much more it comes from playing with the guys every Saturday, going for a pint in the bar with them, going to the same functions, just relaxing and enjoying yourself with your teammates, and also actually being part of the rugby club. So it doesn't matter which team you're on, we're all still in the bar at the end of the day having a pint together. Some of our facilitators play for the first team, some for the seconds. We've got young Colts who started to play for the Colts, in fact now are adult players and are part of the Bumbles, and just see that as their, we're just another team in the club.
A year ago, or wherever they started, they wouldn't have understood what a learning disability is. They would have said, well, learning disability is Down syndrome, or is a person who's not smart or intelligent. Whereas now, if you ask them, they'd say, well, somebody with a learning disability just learns differently, and they can do the same as the rest of us. And I think they need to be acknowledged, because they give up their Saturday mornings, their Sunday afternoons, whenever we play, to come down and support people. And it's for selfish reasons, same as me, in that we enjoy it for ourselves, but it's also because we feel like we're giving back and supporting people to do something that otherwise they might not be able to do. So I think our facilitators need quite a lot of credit for coming down and doing this.
I'm Dennis, and this is the wife, Margaret. We're known to the Bumbles as Mum and Dad. Explain that in a minute or two. We've been involved with the Bumbles 2 years just over. Reason for that is our youngest son played for the Bees rugby, and then our oldest son got involved with the Bumbles itself, and at the moment we've got three sons that actually play for the Bumbles.
Our facilitators,
yeah. And my role actually is I come down on a Saturday, and I've been coming down Saturdays regular for 2 years, and the improvement I've seen in the attitude of the lads themselves is amazing. Mum gets involved regarding looking after the lads personally when she gets a chance. But the Bumbles, it's one of those things, it's something that I never thought would happen. These lads that are classed as disabled, they're not disabled anymore when you watch them play rugby with mixed ability.
They all come out as an equal.
That's correct.
I think that's the thing, isn't it?
Yes,
and the confidence in the lads with learning difficulties is just amazing. From being very, very nervous, they've now got this confidence to mix, not just on the pitch, but socially. Their social skills have improved 100%. We know a couple of the families, purely because we've been involved with Bumbles, and they have said that their boys have actually shown a lot more independence and confidence at home. Some have actually moved out of a family home and moved into perhaps sheltered accommodation where they've got the support there if they need it, but they're actually living independently, and that is just an amazing thing,
yeah.
Because it's a lifelong change. It's not just a change whilst they can play rugby. All the things they're learning now will carry them through for the rest of their life.
Yeah.
And that input has got to be a wonderful thing for a big group. They've got friendships, proper friendships, with the other lads. They meet socially, apart from Bumbles. So it's given them a whole new avenue in their lives. And for us, it's just a lovely feeling that you can be part of something that is giving something back.
Imagine. And this award that you've won, what is it and what's it for?
It's the first year it's ever happened. It's from the Rugby Football Union. It's the President's Beyond Rugby Award, and it's for a group who've not necessarily just an ordinary team, but have gone above and beyond to take rugby as a vehicle for social change out there.
Well, I mean, there's obviously one winner for that, and that's your team.
That's it was really good as well, because we were able to take the guys down to Twickenham. The RFU paid for us to go down to Twickenham, so we watched the England Barbarians game a couple of weekends ago and got this award, and it was just they were ecstatic, the guys were.
Various international games coming up, and we're hoping for 2015 where if we can get all the teams to come across, we can have like a mini World Cup and hopefully show people that people shouldn't be judged by attack, they should be judged for what they are and what they can achieve, not what people put into a picture because they've got this disability or they can't do this. Well, how do you know until you try?
I just think that things are going to go from strength to strength, Rumble and Hinkies. Got a very positive and sort of really good energy. I think it's going to achieve even more than it has achieved already.
I think it's good for inclusive rugby the next few years, not just the Bumblebees. In the past sort of 18 months, as far as I understand, it's massive. The word of inclusive rugby has spread so far and so far since something like that, you know, it's huge. And I don't see why it should be, you know, why shouldn't
any team can start it off. Any team can start it off. As long as you've got that club to help you out and there's people there that will mingle with your team, yes, why not?
Where do I see it in 30 years' time? A Bumblebee's team. A different cookie, a different Gooders, a different me, a different you, a different. Different Anthony, but still being here, and it's just embedded, and it's a team, and it's team on the first team. You go to the rugby web page, and there's a Bumblebees place. It's just another team. That's what it should be. Just another team.